same scientists go to work equipped with cleverly crafted tools of the trade, backstage there's a well-oiled team turning researchers' pipe dreams into reality.
The scientist has a need to record specific data, so we come up with a concept, design it and model it, bounce it off them to make sure they're happy with it, then we make it and test it and give it to them to go and play with.
To create those often ambitious inspirations of the scientist, it takes a resourceful lineup of inventive minds, mechanical and electrical engineers, fitter and turners, boilermakers, electronic whizzers and carpenters.
We mostly build underwater instruments for use in remote locations. They're generally not available off the shelf because the standard items aren't configured how the scientist wants the data and are generally not commercially available.
You won't find the instrumentation at Kmart, that's for sure, but you might find Ames engineers shopping there for parts. Parts like Mr. Men toothbrushes, modified to clean the lenses on this river logger, which is a brainchild from the workshop. It's used for monitoring the amount of sediment that comes down rivers in flood. The workshop is all about innovation, taking standard equipment and modifying them for unconventional jobs. This resuspender used to create a consistent disturbance in sediment is in fact a newly fashioned cordless drill. Another innovative solution is the light trap, designed and fabricated for measuring the population of fish larvae. The offshore automatic weather station network provides crucial seawater temperature and climate information. The very nature of marine science creates immediate challenges. Equipment must be manageable underwater and operate on low power, which requires complex circuitry. Computers must be self-contained and sized to fit in small housing.
The respirometer is a good example. This is the brains of the respirometer. It's used to measure the oxygen consumption of marine organisms. This board controls the water flow, and it measures the temperature and the oxygen levels in the water.
The handiwork of the engineering staff has enabled the inception of the baited remote underwater video system, which is a non-destructive fleet of cameras scattered on the sea floor and used to sample areas too deep and potentially dangerous for research scuba divers. The scientists and engineering team work together in the field to iron out any wrinkles in design, to improve the performance and ensure the gear can capture the data needed. This device is another seafaring video camera, which is used to survey the seabed. The manta logger, dubbed the Bat Board, is a computer for recording underwater observations, enabling fast, accurate monitoring of reef communities. Mud and coral corers are used to burrow the sea floor to extract a sample of environmental and climate history embedded within. In a bid to test these tools, engineers and technicians must also be skilled divers and understand intimately the scientific task at hand. This is just a snapshot of the talent and innovative developments from engineering services that have revolutionised the research capacity here at Ames.